What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the tower. I'm doing another module highlight, and today's module is going to be negative mass projector. I wanted to do this one right after space displacer because multiple people have requested it, and they do play a pretty similar role in the module system these days. So let me get started with it. So this is an armor module, and what it does is if an orb doesn't actually kill an enemy, it will apply a debuff, which will reduce the enemy's damage and speed by a certain percentage, depending on the rarity, up to 50%. And this does work on enemies that wouldn't die to orbs anyways, or even take any damage from orbs at all. So it still does work on elites and fleets. It does work on bosses, of course. They take the 2% per hit anyway. But even regular enemies that would die to orbs in one hit normally, with like the armor battle condition or the orb resistance battle condition, this effect will still apply when they get hit. And then no matter what, it's a max of 50%. That is for both the damage reduction and the speed reduction. So for the value of the unique effect, you actually start off with 40% of the value at the epic. Each hit reduces the damage and speed by 40% as much as you would have at Ancestral, which is honestly not bad just for an epic module. So going from epic to legendary, the legendary does 50% more reduction per hit compared to the epic. Going from legendary to mythic, the mythic does 33% more reduction per hit compared to the legendary. And then going from mythic to ancestral, the ancestral does 25% more per hit compared to the mythic. So I would honestly say a lot of the value is actually towards the start. It does get better, of course, but even at epic, you still get a lot of value out of the module. You could say technically that's not true because for both damage reductions and speed reductions, getting closer to 100% is actually a higher value. Each percentage would be higher value compared to like lower percentages. But I think the epic still does a pretty good job. So for the visual of the module, the main thing you notice is that the orbs actually change how they look. It sort of makes them look bigger, but I don't think the orbs are actually bigger. So every time one of those orbs hits an enemy, depending on your rarity, it will reduce their damage and speed by a certain percent. It's hard to tell with fewer hits that it's actually doing anything, but it's a lot easier to see when you have a lot of hits on an enemy. But yeah, that's what the orbs actually look like. And here's what they look like without negative mass projector, for example. It looks like the white and the regular color are sort of switched. So moving on to the uses for this module. Like I said, this module is pretty similar to Space Displacer, in the way that it's actually a really good assist option if you have the armor assist unlocked. I do think the space displacer is a little bit better, but you do get a lot of things from this module in assist that you don't get from the space displacer. The main thing would be the damage reduction. So this would be a little bit better for buffing your EHP. And then even at epic, you do get the ability to go up to 50% still for the max damage reduction and the max speed reduction. So if you're able to get 50 hits on an enemy, you're still getting the full value as you would at the ancestral. But otherwise, I think this module is a pretty good option for battle conditions where enemies aren't dying in one hit, of course. So any ultimate enemies are really good, especially like fast ultimate, I think. I'm unsure if the speed reduction actually affects how much the fast buff other enemies' speed, because I think this would be very valuable during fast ultimate if that's how it works, because you could technically reduce the boss's speed as well. But also nice for ranged ultimate, slowing them down a lot is very helpful. Maybe also tanks ultimate. And then even like elites and stuff could be useful during like knockback conditions where the enemies have really high mass, you have lower knockback resistance, mass enforcement. Conditions like that could be pretty useful. But even without those, I still think it's a really solid option to have in the assist slot. Definitely helps with getting orb hits on bosses as well, kind of slowing them down on the orb line. So moving on to substats. There are going to be two main substats for this module, and you can probably guess them. I don't actually have them on here, but it is both of the orb substats. So you have orbs and orb speed. The only problem with the orbs is if you are using it as an assist module, then you won't be able to get an orb unless you have a pretty high substat efficiency. But of course, you can still get the extra orbs from your main module if you're using anti-cube portal like I am here. Then you also get the plus two orbs from that. But luckily, the orb speed doesn't round at all. So you can still get value out of that no matter what your substat efficiency is. Other than both the orb substats, there's really not anything specific. It's pretty similar to the space displacer now. So shockwave frequency is a good one. That helps anti-cube portal if you're using that as a main, if you're using that as a primary. Both landmine substats are nice if you want extra stuns with those. Or if you are using like a space displacer and negative mass projector combo, then the landmine chance would be helpful with that. You can also do Death Defy. If you are a Glass Cannon build, that's a pretty good one as well. Wall rebuild's also nice. I think defense percent and health regen could be decent as well if you are using EHP, since this module also helps with EHP. So it kind of goes along with that. But yeah, I don't think there's really any other subsets you would want. I think the other one was maybe shockwave size. I think I had that on my negative mass projector, yeah. If you're using a high range and you need the shockwave to hit enemies, if you're using like anti-cube portal primary, then that could be a good option as well. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So let me know what module you'd like to see next. And yeah, if you have any other questions, you can leave those in the comments as well. And yeah, see ya.